Hello students, I am Mrs. Dipali. I am your moral science teacher for class 3rd. This is your moral science books, The Cradle of Values, part 3. Now we will learn the study the chapter number 1 of moral science, God is everywhere. Do you all know God is everywhere? He is present in each and everything in the universe. But we cannot see him. We do not know that how he looks and where he lives. Now there is a story about a little girl, Tanya, who was one day watching the TV program, and she asked her father, "Daddy, where does the God live?" Her father answered, "Don't you know where the God lives? He lives in everywhere. He lives everywhere and in everything." Then Tanya asked, "But why cannot we see him?" So her father answered, "We cannot see him, but only feel him, like the air. As the air is important for our lives, so the God is present in it." Then he asked her, how did she know that telling a lie is a bad thing? So Tanya answered, "Whenever she tells a lie, she feels uncomfortable in her heart." Her father answered, said to her that if there is someone in our heart who tells us the difference between wrong and right, this someone is the God. So the God is present everywhere, and he is present in air, in you, in me, in plants, in water, in animals, and even in mountains and grains, because he is the creator of the universe. Therefore, he is present in everything. As he has given us all the things we need to survive, so we pray and thank him for all these things. Then Tanya said, "So, father, do we go to pray and thank God in the temple? This is why we go to pray in the temple." Thought of the chapter is, God is omnipresent. I told you omnipresent means present everywhere. He is present in everything and he is present everywhere. Now there are the exercises. First exercises answer these questions. First question is, can we see the God? No, we cannot see the God. Second question, where does the God live? The answer is, the God lives everywhere. Question number 3, why do we pray and thank God? Answer is, we pray and thank God for all the things we need to survive. Now second exercise is, think and say yes or no. First is, God is not present in the animals. It is not correct, so we write it no against it. Second, God provides us all that we need to survive. Yes, because he is the creator of the universe. He has given us all the things. Third is, God is present in the air and water. Yes. Fourth, God makes us feel the difference between good and bad. Yes, because he is present in our heart, and so he can differentiate good and bad for all of us. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you, children. You have to do these exercises in your moral science copy. Do them neatly, and bye-bye.